the ground with Edmonds. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold him to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. Edmonds running out of the shotgun. And this time they were waiting for him, as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll be second down. To throw, it's Murray. Escaping the pressure right. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. Third and goal. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sacked back around the 8. And Nick Bosa so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down. And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Prater's kick is good.
Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on 4th and goal anyway, but the sack on 3rd down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that, and this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them as they come up 1st and 10 at the 40. Lance a handoff here to Mostert. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past.
There he goes, right side. Touchdown, 49ers.
Well, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there.
Gold with the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Daniels on the return, and he tries to get as much as he can here while protecting the football as he dives to the ground. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too.
They've got his man, complete.
Touchdown, Cardinals.
It's so easy to focus on the speed and elusiveness of Kyler Murray, but as he shows right there, don't sleep on the arm strength.
And I tell you from our broadcast booth, because we're pretty close to the 50, we had the best view, a bird's eye view of that throw. And it was an absolute thing of beauty to watch. Never ceases to amaze me, the arm strength of these guys.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Two seconds to go, first quarter. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Play action. Now it's Lance. And looking for Kittle, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. And this one will be brought back to the 22. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Murray now. They'll roll him out right. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. On the handoff, it's Edmonds. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal. And now Murray's going to set up the throw, eluding the pressure right. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Nick Bosa able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal. Murray going to throw. And the pressure gets there. He'll go down. It's a sack. And it is going to bring us to the 2-minute warning. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And a short kick taken at about the 16.
The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window? And oh, a little spin cycle, room to run now. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big connection on that one, 34 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
When we start looking for big-time corners, we're going to start with athleticism, but without technique,
you're not going to make plays as one we just saw there.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. On third down, here comes Mostert. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of five, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on fourth and one? Kyle Shanahan's made the decision. They're going on fourth down. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. Space to run past the 20. And finally taken down at the four-yard line. Fourth and short, got a whole lot more than he bargained for. He almost scored.
Yeah, how about that? Because you know how it is when you get all those bodies near the line of scrimmage. You often get engaged by blockers, and you can't get your hands on the ball carrier. And he breaks free. He goes almost the distance.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Elijah Mitchell, as the first half is winding down. And the Niners, if they can convert the extra point, they'll grab the lead. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that will give them the lead here as we get on towards halftime. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense as they take over here with 11 seconds remaining. Murray now on first down. Flush to his right. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. A final shot before half for Murray. He's going to float this one deep right side. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Wilson.
Nothing.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. Daniels on the return. And he tries to get as much as he can here while protecting the football as he dives to the ground. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
From the 27, Murray. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. First down, Murray. That's out to the flat for Edmonds. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Throwing on first down is Murray, rolling to his right. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Dancing to his left. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. Now a give to Edmonds. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. They're going for it. Hits Murray. Flushed out right. Going for it all. That's going to be caught by Kirk for a Cardinals touchdown. Christian Kirk there to make the grab. And the Cardinals have retaken the lead. Cliff Kingsbury going to decide here to leave the offense out and go for two. It appears they're going to throw for it with Murray. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Coming up on a second and six. Now a give, right side. Mitchell, he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking of throwing to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the first down, and then some.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
And he's taken down inside the 30.
And here we are in the fourth quarter. Program, we're watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
On first down, Lance getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
78 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. After he cleared the line of scrimmage, nice little hole developed.
Yeah, great blocking right there at the start. But how about his vision, finding the open spaces and letting his feet carry him to them?
They're going to run the sweep. It's Samuel. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Debo Samuel, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the 49ers have retaken the lead. So now an extra point doesn't help much. They'll try to go for 2 to make the difference a field goal, and they can lead it by 3. They'll look to throw. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So that effort gives him a 3-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And he tries to get as much as he can here while protecting the football as he dives to the ground. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Able to find Ertz. A gain of 6 there on 1st. Working with his 2nd and 4. Back to throw, Murray. Being chased out left. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Murray to throw. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. From down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. Throwing quickly, this is caught by Kirk.
He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow.
Prater for the extra point, and that will make this a 4-point game. Touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Escaping the pressure right. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. Finds a seam inside the 40. And Lance will have the first down as he's able to slide to avoid the contact there at the end of the play. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Back to throw. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And oh, that would get a wide up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone, probably should have been. Third down coming up. An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. They'll look to throw. He'll swing this out to Mostert. And out of bounds right around the 20.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down, got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding of where they are on the field?
One final try now for Lance. And this is going to be caught. It's caught. And they've won the football game.
So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners. So the victory here for San Francisco, and it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises. Really, both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, for not, my not, for Lex and the chip, my not, polite, the set, but I've been taking.